This 3D printer is mostly 3D printed. And with mostly 3D printed, I mean that anything that can be 3D printed is 3D printed. Just look at the linear rails, the lead screws, the frame, and even the belt is 3D printed. Let's talk about the first of several awesome maker projects here at the Midwest RepRap Festival 2022 in Goshen, Indiana. Guten Tag, everybody. I'm Stefan, and welcome to CNC Kitchen. John is the father of this machine and is a skilled engineer and designer. I already visited his booth at the Midwest RepRap Festival 2019 and was very happy to see him and his creations again this year. John told me that he started designing fully 3D printed linear rails with recirculating ball bearings, well, fully printed besides the steel BBs on the inside, and then got the idea to make a complete 3D printer using this idea. This resulted in the Malbot, an open source i3 style 3D printer, where the whole design, including beautiful drawings, is available on GitHub for you to download, get inspired, and to improve upon. John told me that this machine has already been running for several hundreds of hours with minimum maintenance. Most of the parts are printed from simple PLA. He only used ABS for the stepper motor mounts because they became too soft in PLA. All of the axes are running on his custom 3D printed linear rails and didn't feel too flimsy for what they are. I really enjoyed seeing that for each of the axes he also applied a different technique to drive it. The X-axis is conventionally belt driven, except that the belt is printed from TPU. John designed the model so that it can be printed in vase mode to get really smooth surfaces. Since a TPU printed part is, of course, not reinforced like a regular belt, it's not as stiff, but if you don't print with high acceleration, it still does a remarkable job. John only told me that he has to release the tension regularly because otherwise it stretches over time. The y-axis, so the bed, is driven by rack and pinion, which I haven't seen on any other machine yet. The distance between the rack and the pinion can be adjusted to minimize play to keep printing quality high. The z-axis is driven by two 3D printed simple trapezoidal lead screws, which work quite well because the load on them is minimal. They aren't even significantly greased and were only coated with some Teflon spray when new. The rest of the machine is kept very simple with a RAMS control board, a V6 Bowden hot end to reduce the weight on the X carriage, and an unheated glass bed. When John designed the Malbot in 2018 and 19, his goal was never to make the cheapest or best performing machine, but he challenged himself how far he could push 3D printed components, and I think he very well succeeded in this regard. This is one of the reasons why I enjoy visiting these events so much. It was so awesome to meet people with that much dedication and skill who show off their projects to demonstrate what can be done and inspire others to learn and improve on it. John is not only a gifted designer of 3D printed bearings, but he also showed off a bunch of other 3D printed print-in-place objects and puzzle boxes. So if you're into that, check out the links I put in the description. This 3D printer, printed from mostly PLA, shouldn't be kept in a hot environment for too long for obvious reasons. But if you ever need to print high temp materials like ABS, PC or nylon, or just use your machine in a cold basement, check out the Wambam Hotbox. Wambam, the creators of the Hotbox, flexible build plates for filament and resin printers, and the Mutant Tool Swapping System, sponsored the videos from my trip to MRRF 2022. So if you're looking for a high quality printer upgrade, want to print materials you weren't able before, or want to convert your simple printer to a multi-tool machine, check out Wambam using the link below.